In this video, I'm going to show you how we can find the last not empty row, column, or value in Excel. So in this particular case, see, we have this column. And if we wanted to find the last non-empty row, that would be this row 16. We don't want to get any of these empties in the middle, just this row 16 right there. So to do that, we can use XMatch. So I'm going to do equals XMatch. And in XMatch, I'm going to provide a lookup value. Quote, star for now, and quote. Do a comma after that, and then I'm going to provide this column A to search. Now, if you didn't want to do the whole column, you can do a particular range like this. It's really up to you. In this example, I'm going to do the whole column, but you can also do it within a range if you wanted to. So I'll do the whole column A, and then I'm going to do a comma. Now, when I get to this third option, I'm going to choose this wildcard character match, comma. And then after this, we have this mode to search last to first, because we want to go down up to find this. So I'm going to do last to first, and finally close parentheses and hit enter so you can see what I get. So as you can see, I got 16. Now, in the event when you have, for example, some cells here that are formulas, but they return blank. So for example, I can say equals double quotes here. So it's kind of like a blank cell, but this cell is no longer really blank. So in this case, see, this would get us 17. Now, if you wanted this formula to still return 16, what you could do, you could go here after the star and add question mark star. And in this case, basically, we're saying we want at least one character before we do a match by doing that question mark in the middle. And if I hit enter, you'll see we get a 16, even though in this row 17, we have this formula that returns the blank. Now, if I didn't want the row number, but I wanted the actual value, then I could do it using XLOOKUP. Now, you could do index and use this 16 in that. That should be just valid too. But I'm going to use XLOOKUP to just do it in one formula. I'll do XLOOKUP. And again, as a lookup value, I'm going to go ahead and select that same star question mark star. And again, the same logic applies here. If you want the actual non-blank cell, you would just do star, comma. And then as a lookup array, I'm going to select that column A, comma, and when I get to return array, I'm going to select that same column A, comma, and then we have if not found. In this case, I'm just going to go with double quotes just to return blank, basically, if everything is blank, comma, and then again, wildcard character match number 2, comma, and finally search last to first, which is this negative 1 option. Close parentheses, hit enter, and you should be able to see how I get this last option. If I delete this one from here, you'll see it will match this one. So if I undo this, it will move to this. And if I just type hello here, you'll see how it grabs that hello. So you'll see this updates to 19 now too. So this is the row number. This is the value itself. These formulas would be okay if you're working with text values, but you may find some weird things if you actually have some numbers. So if I go ahead and, for example, enter a number here, you'll see the last one still returns 19 and hello. And the reason for that is because this match in our XMatch and XLOOKUP actually will match text only. So what I can do to fix this problem, I can just take this range and just wrap it within this function value to text and close parentheses around this. And if I had entered now, see, now it returns 21, which is probably what you would want. And that same thing I could do with this. So I can take this first one. We don't have to do the second one. We just have to do this first lookup array value to text, just like that, for that range, and hit enter. You'll see that would give me this. If I didn't have a number, it's still gonna work and it's gonna return the correct thing. So there you go, a couple of different formulas. These same formulas should work for a row as well. So if you wanted to find, let's say in this row three, the last non-empty value, which would be the 6, you would go here and do equals xlookup star question mark star in quotes, comma, and then as a lookup array, I'm gonna do value to text, and then I'm gonna select this row 3, close parentheses, comma, and then return array is gonna be that same row 3, comma, if not found, I'll just say return blank, double quote, comma, match wildcard characters, comma, and finally we want search last to first, -1 option. If I enter, see that returns 6 because that's pretty much the last non-empty in this. If I had another number or text or whatever here, that should return that value, as you can see. For this formulas, by the way, if you wanted to find the first one, you can do that one too. So all you would have to do is just switch this formula, this last option, to do search first to last. So if I do that, see, it will give me this first one, 6. And if I do -1, well, you see where this is going. It's gonna find the last one. And then if you wanted to find the column number, you would just use X match. So X match, again, the same star question mark star in quotes, comma, lookup array would be value to text. And then this whole row over here, close parentheses, and then comma, and then I'm gonna do wildcard characters, comma, and then again, last to first, -1 option, close parentheses, hit enter, and as you can see, it says this is column 7, so it counts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's correct. And if you wanted the first one, same way, you could just do 1 here, and that's column number 3, right here, the first non-empty cell. And there it is. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.